Let's look at the sales invoice. How are we going to do? The way of raising sales invoice will be the same with the quotation chapter earlier. With the customer name and item codes here, what I want to highlight to you will be the tax inclusive. The item is selling at 25 ringgit and your tax amount 150, so 26.50. So if you are the one who bear the cost of the GST, you just stick on tax inclusive. So the total selling price is 25, which you are bearing 142 tax.
Then how can I check system are posting to the right account?
For the sales invoice, so each item code we can send it to the relative stock group that which will post to the respective GL account. If you want to see whether it's correct account, you can always come to here and turn on the account code. So as a result here, you'll be seeing additional one column where you can see all are posted to the different GL code.
Okay, so as I can see, so this is posted to 502,000 for item message prepaid. Then how about if I wish to change it to other sales account, can I just direct change it here?
Okay, so here if you want to edit the account, you can always pull down the menu here and type, switch the column search and type the account that you want to post to. Let's say accessories account.
Okay, other than this, then anyway I can check this invoice are inserted by which user?
For the history of the data entry on the documents, you can always right click, select audit trail here. Then there will be a list of histories that when was it inserted and who is the user who key in this document. Now one more I want to highlight to everybody is if you wish to print a batch of invoices rather than one by one, you can always come to the system here. Right click, batch print. Then from here you can select the date you wish and the customer or whatsoever parameter and apply and preview as usual.
Okay, then other than this in SQL, right? Is it compulsory I must do DO or can I just skip DO, then I can direct insert from invoice but I wish to print DO report?
Here in the design of SQL accounting, there's always two ways to go about it. Number one, if you're going on the conventional method, you can raise DO first, then you raise invoice where you transfer from DO. In this case, the system will know this invoice is transferred from DO. DO will be the level or will be the entry point to deduct or post to stock card. Whereas there are customers that they want to skip DO where they want to print invoice and DO together in this invoice entry screen. So you can always only key the invoice here and the system will know this invoice is not transferred from DO. The stock deduction will be happen here in invoice entry. You can always print invoice and DO together where you copy the DO format to this invoice entry. So you can select two to print together. To clone or to copy the DO to the invoice format, you can always go to tools, report designer, then you'll be seeing this screen. This will be all your reports available in the system. So you locate the DO format that you wish to copy from, then you can click on clone button. So give a new name, let's say DO, okay. Then you want to copy or clone this DO to sales invoice, okay, done. So now when you print your invoice, you can see there's additional format DO here. So in this way, you can print DO and invoice from this single entry screen.